Next, we received a number of questions on the Edith North Rogers STEM Scholarship. James, could you describe the scholarship in more detail?
Sure. The Rogers STEM Scholarship Program provides up to 9 months, limited to a total of $30,000, to qualifying individuals that are enrolled in STEM fields, that is science, technology, engineering, and math. Those scholarships are awarded on a quarterly basis in January, April, July, and October. To date, VA has awarded $54 million in Edith North Rogers STEM Scholarship.
Okay. So, can you use the STEM scholarship to qualify for VETTEC or the Veteran Readiness Employment Program if they have run out of original GI Bill entitlements?
The short answer is no. Veterans have to have at least 1 day of remaining entitlement out of the 36 months of standard entitlement that they have under the post-9/11 GI Bill in order to qualify for the VETTEC program. And the same goes for VR&E benefits.
Does the STEM scholarship pay for an entire semester or quarter if you have at least 1 day left, like the GI Bill does? Or if a month is left, does it only pay benefits for that month of tuition?
Thanks for that question, Monique. As I mentioned previously, the Rogers STEM Scholarship is limited by law to up to 9 months of additional entitlement for the pursuit of a STEM program. Consequently, VA does not have the authority to extend benefits, even for a short period of time, up to the end of a term. It's also worth noting that by law, VA is limited in the amount of scholarships that it can actually award during any given fiscal year. So not everyone who is eligible to receive the scholarship will be able to receive those benefit payments.
What about using a STEM scholarship to pay for certifications while also using a STEM scholarship to, let's say, pay for my undergraduate STEM degree?
The Rogers STEM Scholarship benefits can only be paid for the pursuit of either an undergraduate degree in a STEM field or a program leading to teaching certifications. Now, if the charges for a license or certification exam are a part of that undergraduate degree or teaching program, then we can pay benefits towards those costs as well. However, we cannot use the STEM scholarship money to pay for some separate reimbursement for the cost of a licensing and certification program that's not part of that STEM field degree program or teaching certification requirement. So it can't be used for a licensing and certification exam the way that regular GI Bill benefits can.
Are there any plans to extend the STEM scholarship to graduate programs? We've seen this question so many times.
That is a great question, and I hear it all the time as well. We do have ongoing discussions with our partners in Congress and share with them what we've heard from GI Bill students. However, graduate programs are currently not approved for the Rogers STEM Scholarship Program at this time.
Thank you for that. A few individuals have asked about the STEM scholarship qualifications. One actually noted, "I recently applied for the STEM scholarship and was denied. I reviewed the qualifications and I felt confident I met the requirements. Could you please clarify some of the common reasons for an individual to be denied?"
Sure. There are a number of different qualifications in order to receive the STEM scholarship benefits. First of all, you need to be enrolled in an undergraduate STEM program or a teaching certification. If it's a degree program, it needs to require at least 120 semester hours or 180 quarter hours in order to qualify. Second, the individual has to have completed at least 60 semester hours or 90 quarter credit hours toward that degree program. And third, the individual must have exhausted their post-9/11 GI Bill benefit entitlement or be within 6 months of exhausting their benefits at the time of the application. As required by law, when we evaluate applications, we also prioritize and rank the individuals based upon a number of factors which were spelled out in the law, such as individuals who are eligible for the post-9/11 GI Bill at the 100% benefit level, and also those that require the most credit hours in order to complete their programs. This prioritization is done primarily because the STEM scholarship program funding is limited currently to $75 million per year. If you've been denied for a Rogers STEM scholarship in the past, because you don't currently meet one of those program requirements, such as not completing at least 60 semester or 90 quarter hours, or if we've run out of money. We would strongly suggest that you reapply for those benefits once you meet those eligibility requirements, or when the fiscal year rolls over and there's more money in the pot to pay out for the Rogers STEM scholarship program.
What should an approved scholarship recipient expect, or what are the next steps a GI Bill student should take with the school or VA, for that fact, to start using their benefits to ensure that payment is being made to the school?
Thanks for that question. VA pays the Rogers STEM scholarship benefits while the student remains enrolled in the program for which they received the award. So once you're in your STEM program, we will start paying out those benefits. As I mentioned previously, it does provide up to 9 months of additional benefits, and that's 9 months of full-time benefits. So, for example, if you're going to school less than full-time, then it would extend out beyond 9 months. So we'll pay for the entire 9 months up to that $30,000 cap per individual. Once we receive the application and determine eligibility for a specific individual, we do notify the school certifying official at the school by mail, phone, and or email to let them know that the student does meet the eligibility requirements for the Rogers STEM scholarship, so that the school can provide us with additional data that we need on the program, such as the program name, the credit hours that have been completed, and the remaining credit hours needed in order to complete the program. That allows us to do the prioritization and ensure that the other additional eligibility requirements are met. After a student is approved, we will issue a Rogers STEM Scholarship Certificate of Eligibility to the student that will include information on the scholarship effective date, the termination date, and a projected date of when we would expect the entitlement to exhaust. In addition, we also submit that information to the school certifying official so that that individual knows to send the additional enrollment information into VA regarding the tuition and fees so that we can get the payments out for those additional 9 months.
Thanks so much for that great information. If you're actually interested in applying for the STEM scholarship, you can go to our website at va.gov/education to apply. If you have more questions, please do not hesitate to call us at 1-888-GI-BILL-1. That's actually 1-888-442-4551. You can call between the hours of 7 a.m. and 6 p.m. Central Time, Monday through Friday.